I got started doing martial arts formally when I was in high school, about 1989. Much like every young kid around that time, I just needed something to do, and that happened to be martial arts. It looked cool, and I tried it, and I liked it. After high school and college, I met a man named Nick who was wearing an Aikido t-shirt, and we talked, and he told me about this dojo where he trained in Aikido. I was very interested in that. And that was in 1993, and ever since then, I've been doing Aikido. Martial arts means a lot of things. I like to define martial arts as an umbrella term. And in that umbrella, you have different things like competitions, demonstration techniques, basics, weapons, etc. And certainly self-defense is contained in that. A better way to look at it would be to call them techniques of self-preservation, as opposed to self-perfection in martial arts. By self-preservation, I look for a technique that anyone can do, not just me and my body type, but anyone can do it, and they can learn it that day. It's not gonna take them a year to learn it or 5 years to learn it. It's gonna take them that day to learn it, that hour that they're in class to learn it. If they practice it outside of class, which is what I pick, things that they can learn and practice if they never see me again, they'll only get better at it. To give you an idea of some of the techniques we teach and where I draw them from, for example, we have a whole series of techniques where we deal with different ways you can be grabbed from behind. Being grabbed from behind is dangerous because you didn't see it happen, and so you have to learn how to escape these holds immediately, and you're not gonna be able to do that if you're just struggling the whole time and panicking. So we pull those techniques from Aikido. That's the Japanese art. It's an art based on non-resistance. By non-resistance, it doesn't mean that we just let whatever happened happen to us. It means that we move in a direction that an opponent cannot resist. You know, that we move in directions that they can't put their own power into, so that we can use our own power in a direction where they have none. But we have another series where we look at being held at bay with a knife. And we have a whole series of escapes and counters for that they take from Kali. Kali is a Filipino art. It's a weapons-based art. They use the knife and the machete. And so they have a lot of techniques to deal with an attacker that has a blade of any length, whether it's from the front or from the rear, what have you. Our classes, they're just geared towards the kind of person that maybe you can't commit to a regular training schedule, but you still have the opportunity to be able to participate in a high-quality self-defense class at a price you can afford, and that's what we do. I really think that it's important to be prepared. It's kind of like if you have a car accident, and after the accident you want to buckle your seatbelt. You know, that's really the lesson, the idea I want to give the people. Calamities don't happen every day. Like, that's not my premise, that we live in a malevolent world. But when they do happen, we have to be prepared. That's the defense. That's the best defense against anything, is preparation and foreknowledge. So if you have an opportunity to study or learn or take an afternoon, bring your wife or your daughter with you or what have you, your friends, come on out. You know, we have seen plenty of classes where it was just a bunch of friends that got together, a bunch of women, and they said, hey, let's go check out this class together. We'll do it. And it's always a good time. We have fun. It's relevant, you know, and that's the point, also relevancy. Like I said, we don't sit there on top of our dojo mountain and have you do katas that don't matter to you. We really try to take things that are relevant to you, the individual, that's you. The easiest way to get a hold of us, like I said, is the toraha.com website or the tribek.com website. Our Jacksonville location is downtown at 700 East Union Street. It's closer towards the stadium. It's just past the Matthews Bridge. It's really a way of being of service. You know, the martial arts, especially in the Japanese martial arts, they talk about the samurai culture a lot. And the word samurai literally means to be of service, you know. At that time, they would say, to one's lord. I feel like, as a martial artist, it's my way of being of service to my actual community.